स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक फ्रॉम मॉड्यूल 3, दैट इज रिपोर्ट राइटिंग। डेफिनेशन, फीचर्स, पर्पस। So everybody know what is a report. It's a very common term. Anybody can write down a report. Like we can say ki a nurse in a hospital reports to the doctor. Yes. And a foreman at the end of the day reports to the manager the progress of the work carried out in the supervision. The manager of a bank sends a periodic report to the head office on the status of depositions and etc. Okay, a publishing firm keep on introducing a new series of paperbacks into the market. Yes, the managing director of a bank would like to report on the efficacy of the measures introduced by him to promote efficiency. And reports thus are a part of our lives, be it school reports, newspaper reports, television reports, radio reports, etc. From time to time, the government sets up committees and commissions to report on various issues of social, political and economic importance. There are various parliamentary committees such as Committee on Human Resources, Committee on Agriculture, Committee on Industry, Committee on Science and Technology, Committee on Environment and Forests, etc. that are set up to discuss, analyze and report on various matters pertaining to the respective ministries. Okay, so reports are the common needs of people in daily work. So we need to write down reports day to day work for submission to other person. Okay, so what is a report? A report is a major form of technical, business, professional life. In writing a report, a person who possesses certain facts, ideas or suggestions useful for courses of human actions transmit this information to another person who wants to use it. So in simple terms, we can we just define it here. The word report is derived from the Latin reportere, means to bring back. Over a period of time, it has evolved to mean that the gathered information is unbiased and evidence-based. So the word report is derived from the Latin term reportere, to bring back. Over a period of time, it has evolved to mean that the gathered information is unbiased and evidence-based. It is very important for a report that it must be fact-based, it must be truthful, it must be factual. And on the basis of this, we can say that a report is usually a piece of factual writing based on evidence containing organized information on on a particular topic. So a report is usually a piece of factual writing based on evidence containing organized information on a particular topic. So what we have to remember, it is factual, based on evidence, organized information, topic, based on a particular topic. Okay, so now the question is that why you people need to learn to write down a report. What are its objectives? What is its needs? So we can say that objectives and purposes. Number one, to present a record of accomplished words. Accomplished work. Number two, to record an experiment. Number three, to record research findings or technical specifications, to document schedules, timetables, etc. To document current status, to record and clarify complex information, to record and clarify complex informations. To record and clarify complex informations for future reference. To present information to a large number of people. To a large number of people. To present organized information on a particular topic. And to recommend actions. So students, see again here what are the objectives. Your first objective is to present a record of accomplished work. Like if you want to give a complete report of a report, report of a work, we can write down. And to record an experiment, we can also write down a complete record of a experiment. To record research findings, if we are doing some research work, we can also make a report of that. To document schedules, timetables, etc., we can write down a report. We can also write down a report to current to note down the current status, to record the clarity and complex information for future reference, to present information to a large number of people, to present organized information on a particular topic and to recommend actions. Recommend is suggestion, to suggest actions. So these are the generally objectives of a report. So after understanding these purposes and objectives of writing a report, we will understand that what are the characteristics of a good report. What can we people do to make a report a good report, an effective report, and a correct report? Like in earlier discussions and earlier topics, we have discussed about the 7 C's of technical communication, the 7 C's of business letter writing. Though because a report is also a type of technical document, so we people must follow the same 7 C's here also. We will again discuss here the 7 C's, like clarity, conciseness, compactness, complete, coherent, and compact, considerate. So beside all these 7 C's, there are some other characteristic features must like it must be based on, because we are discussing here the report, it is directly related with facts. So it must be factual. And accurate. Relevant. Considerate. It must be relevant. Reader oriented. Objective. Detailed and documented. So clarity means the information must provide clear meaning of the written matter. Conciseness means time saving, without unnecessary elaborations or contents. Compact means nothing should be left outside of the report. It must be complete in itself. Proper introduction, discussion, conclusion. Coherent, dependent on the topic. Relativity among the sentences from one another in reference of the topic. Compact means each and every word and sentence must have some meaning contributory to the objective of the report. Considerate means reader oriented. The reader must understand what you have written. So it must be written keeping in mind the mental level of the reader. And because a report must be factual, it is based on facts, it is its quality also, it is its feature that it must be factual, fact-based, not imaginative or fanciful. एक्यूरेट मीन्स करेक्ट एग्जैक्ट रीडर ओरिएंटेड रीडर मस्ट अंडरस्टैंड इट इट मस्ट हैव सम ऑब्जेक्टिव एंड इफ देर इज अ नीड ऑफ एग्जाम्पल्स एंड रिकमेंडेशन सो इट मस्ट ऑल्सो प्रोवाइड ऑल दीज थिंग्स नथिंग शुड लेफ्ट आउटसाइड. So after learning what is a report, what are the objectives when writing a report, what are the features of a very good report, we will understand the types of reports. So generally, what are the types of report? On the basis of purpose, frequency or mode of reporting, reports can be classified as follows. Number one, informative. Number two, periodic. Number three, oral or written. Informative or analytical. Periodic or special. So these are based on purpose, these are based on frequency and oral and written mode of presentation. So informative reports are generally written for information. So informative reports focus on documenting new information. Analytical reports assess information in order to propose a course of action. So informative reports focus on documenting and analytical reports assess information in order to propose a course of action. Another is periodic and special. So generally the periodic reports, periodic or routine reports are either informational or analytical in their purpose, as they are prepared and presented at regular prescribed intervals in the usual routine of business. They are called periodic or routine reports. They may be submitted annually, semi-annually, quarterly, monthly, fortnightly, weekly or even daily. So these reports are dependent on frequency, that you are submitting a report of 1 day, 2 day, of 1 week, 1 month, of 1 year, etc. Now come to this special reports are related to a single occasion or situation. Special reports are related to a single occasion or situation, and periodic or routine reports are prepared and presented at regular prescribed intervals in the usual routine of business. So periodic or routine report, prepared at regular or prescribed intervals. and special reports are related to a single occasion. Okay, now come to written and oral reports. When we will talk about written and oral reports, reports can be oral and written depending upon the mode of presentation. When you rejoin duty after attending an international seminar, you meet your officer and report about the deliberations of the seminar. So this type of reporting comes under the oral report. An oral report is simple and easy to present. It may communicate an impression or an observation. While oral reports are useful, written reports are always preferred as they enjoy several advantages. Oral and written reports, these are having their separate features, like written reports are immediate feedback is not possible. So written reports are quite useful, and oral reports immediate feedback is possible. If we want to know about something, then we can talk. So these are And these are it take them time to write down something. Okay. Written reports contribute to the permanent record. Yes, and they can these are the number of times you will write or you will say something, you can change the words, but you can't change a written record every time. Okay. Audience can ponder over these reports and their own space. So these can be written reports can be edited, reviewed, stored and retyped. I mean to say that when you write a report, it can be edited. Reviewed, yes, but it can't be referred to again and again. You can't refer. So, having less professional value. Yes, but when we will talk about the written records, so have more professional value. So and when we will talk the importance of reports, these are the legal responsibilities. Legal responsibility, they can be used as legal instruments. Your activities as an employee and your competence at work are reflected through reports. So reports are very much important. A report is a basic management tool used in decision making, hence it is extremely important for organization of all the types. Reports are vital, especially for large scale organizations that are engaged in multifarious activities handled by different departments. So their top executive cannot keep a personal watch over all these activities, so they have to base their decisions on the reports they get from the heads of various departments. So for large organization, reports are indispensable. Reports wear a lot of significance both to the organizations in which they arise and to the organization they are submitted to. So Here we can say that a report is the only transferable product of a professional. Reports enable decision making and problem solving organization. Problem solving in organizations. So reports helps the authorities in planning new ventures. And reports are very important means of information. And reports serve as a measure of growth, progress, success of an organization too.